No other city in Michigan can lay claim to being the third oldest city west of the Appalachian Mountains in the United States, but Sault Ste. Marie, which is the oldest city in Michigan, can. With the French settling the area in 1668, the amount of history here is astounding. As a way to offer tangible glimpses into the past, Water Street has some amazing historical sites that have been restored to show what life was like for our fur traders and early European settlers to the area. Open from late June through Labor Day, these sites offer a great portrayal of early Sault Ste. Marie. The homes on historic Water Street allow visitors to see firsthand what life was like for the fur traders that helped make the area a thriving center of trade and commerce, most notably between the French and Native Americans. These buildings are restored and ran through a cooperation of the Chippewa County Historical Society, the Sioux Historic Sites, and the City of Sault Ste. Marie. The restoration is obviously a lengthy process, as getting these sites back to looking as they had originally is a very laborious task. These restorations are a point of pride in the area, with great respect for the history, and thus, there is a push to add more to the list of restored sites. The Kemp Coal Dock is one of the restored structures on Water Street. The site pays tribute to the industry that led Sault Ste. Marie in the past, all of which relied heavily on the natural resources readily available near and around the Sault Ste. Marie area. This structure is devoted to displaying the industrial history of the region. These industries were drawn by the hydroelectric power potential, as well as the obvious proximity to transportation on the lakes. However, as resources began to lessen, the benefits to having the industry began to lessen as well, and they became no longer viable to keep open. In 2007, the Kemp Coal Dock was opened for public viewing as a museum of the industrial history in Sault Ste. Marie. Known as the Snowshoe Priest, Bishop Frederick Barraga has left an indelible mark on Sault Ste. Marie and the surrounding region. Beginning in 1835, he worked with the Ojibwe and traveled across the Upper Peninsula ministering for Native Americans. Then, in 1864, after he had been named Bishop of the region, a home was purchased for him in Sault Ste. Marie. Following the decision the diocese made to move headquarters to Marquette, Bishop Barraga's home became a Catholic school, followed by being a residence for both church and school staff. Moved to its current location in 1986, the home was restored and opened to the public in 2014. The Henry Rowe Schoolcraft is another historic building that has been restored for visitors to experience. It was moved to its current setting and restored to the original appearance in 1979. The office was where Schoolcraft would spend his time working as the first Indian agent in the area. The Johnston home is believed to be one of the oldest homes in Michigan, being built in 1796. John Johnston, an Irish fur trader of high status, built the home along with his wife Susan, the daughter of a local Chippewa chief. The couple had 8 children, and the family was well known in the area. Their home is often a destination for people trading in or traveling through the area. Thanks for visiting, and we hope to see you soon. This experience has been brought to you by Sault Ste. Marie Convention and Visitors Bureau in partnership with Hospitality Mentality 360.